another way of this one, hustle. Already the types of retailers, itinerary retailers, fixed shop retailers. In that we are already completed small scale fixed shops. Here six we have: general stores, single line stores, salty stores, street shops, second hand shops, second shops. Now the second type of fixed shop retailers is large scale fixed shops. Here the establishment of this type of shops is having the more and more investment worth. If you have the more and more investment value of money only, you may ready to establish this type of shops. So here operations are also more. So here what are the features they say here? The heavy investment is required for this establishment. This one here, the first point, huge sum required for establishment. Just now I said here the more and more money will be required for proper establishment of these type of fixed shops. Those are will be large scale fixed shops, and they have relatively large establishment in comparison to small scale retail shops. Relatively large, yes or no? Compared to this, it will be more large scale operative required, so that there is a relatively large establishment in compare with the small scale fixed shop retailers. Now the types, what are the types are there in the large scale fixed shop? Just now only said departmental stores, multiple shops, and mail orders trade, and cooperative consumers, cooperative stores. These are the way we have. In that first one, departmental stores. What is the meaning of departmental stores? What are advantages, disadvantages will be there. Now we have to discuss. Next, multiple shops we have to discuss. Mail order trading also discuss. Then consumers cooperative also we have to discuss. Now first one, departmental stores. So here the number of departments will be there for particular business which is established by the one person or few of members. But the management will be done within the same roof. So various departments will be there. Those will be maintained by the same roof only. So here for example, RS Brothers, we can take here. Those shops are various places we have, multiple shops. That's initially in one place itself. In Punjab Uttar, in Sikandarabad area, we have the RS Brothers. Here, the complete building will be there. So here, various departments will be there. All they are maintained business for the dresses shops only. Here the children, here the women's, here the men's, like that other stores, department. These all will be various departments. If you want to buy the children's dresses, this is the ground floor, first, second, third floor. You may come here, they will be said where you want to buy, where you want to go, what type of product you want to buy it. At that time, their particular person says to you, the customer, I want to buy the children dresses. So immediately they said, you may go for the third floor itself. You may men's for say first floor, you may women's for second floor, like that they said. These all the various departments will be there, but this is a complete ownership view. This will be one roof only. So that the departmental stores are having the more investment money, but there is a number of differences are will be falling and same in the roof itself. So that all the management ownership will be done with the single roof itself only. So what are the advantages with the departmental store? While we have to establishing the departmental stores, what are the advantages will be there? Firstly, it is established in central location. Wherever the place is more demandable, views members of public come to particular place, they are establishing these type of departmental stores. That is the first advantage. We have to observe it, which place is center place, there they are establishing the departmental stores. That is the first advantage. So nextly, it sells different type of products. Just now I said here, different variety of products they may be sold away. So lot of variety of products may be available to the customers. So nextly, it is another advantage. It facilitates the economic large scale distribution. Large scale of distribution is possible in this retailer, means wholesaler, through they buy the huge quantity of products and distribute it to the customers in large scale itself. more and more business will be available in this departmental stores. This is also another advantage. It is facilitating the economics of large scale distribution. It helps in middle, it helps to facing a problem of middlemen will be throw it out. It helps to eliminating the middlemen. So directly they may be sold to the customers with the discount rates. So this is what the advantages. It is established in central locations and it sells a different type of products, providing the large scale distribution and eliminating the middlemen in between the wholesaler or retailer to consumers. In between, brokers are like that will be there, those are will be eliminated with this departmental stores. Whereas disadvantages from this, departmental stores are also having some of the disadvantages, limitations. What are they? Operating cost is high in departmental stores. Those are the spending amount is more, that should be operating cost. For operation purpose, for operating activities purpose, we have to pay more money as expenditure. So that is the first limitation, is that operating cost is high. Secondly, size of store large, so difficult in personal attention. There is a small shop only we have, personal attention is full. Whereas this type of departmental, if the owner may be in children dresses department, the main department, how can he observe it? So that is another problem for attention of the personnel. So if it is a large size is more large, so that difficult to show the personal attention on particular way. This is what another disadvantage. Next, prices are high due to large operating cost. Just now only said operating cost is high, automatically the product cost also will be increased. So here 10 rupees of manufacturing rate, it will come to wholesaler, it becomes the 13 rupees. Now go for the departmental, here they want 1 rupee profit, it will become 14. But here the operating cost is there and other expenses will be there. These all will be including this one, then only they said the 16 rupees. Like that situations will be happen, that the right price of the particular product will be high. That is also another problem. Next, required huge capital. Compared to other itinerant retailers or other way of establishment of retailers, here the huge capital will be required. That is another limitation. And finally, usually the departmental stores are not suited far off posh localities, situated in far off posh localities. So middlemen segments are there in different places. There is no choice to available the particular stores. Where is the posh, so locality will be there only they are established. For which are not developed, there is no departmental stores, so there is not at all available for the middle segment residentials locations. These are the some of the disadvantages relating to departmental stores. Even departmental stores are maintained successfully, get the profits also. These are the advantages and these are the disadvantages. This is the first type of departmental store in large scale fixed shops. So what are they? Departmental store will be there, multiple shops will be there, mail order retailing trade will be there, consumers cooperate. Now go for the multiple shops. This is what we have, the departmental stores.